that makes the movie even better. Okay, so that tells you that Diana is absolutely a fashion icon. And so is Tracee Ellis Ross, but we gotta remember that she goes in her mammy's closet to shop all the time. Hello there, Bellas. If you have not already done so, please remember to like, share to Facebook, subscribe, and visit uptopbeauty.com. Today's looky-looky would be my Chi-Chi sunshades. Ooh. And my cold weather taupe turban. Love it. It makes me feel like a Hollywood starlet, you know, like D. Diana. Ooh. And if you are not already a part of our book club, please remember to hit the Patreon link below and or the join button here on the YouTube. And for a small monthly fee of $5, you babies, yes you, can be privy to all the shenanigans before the YouTube gets it, if the YouTube gets it. Now, let's continue talking about Call Her Miss Ross, the unauthorized biography of Diana Ross by J.R.T. Since they were both so obviously on the same wavelength, Gordy and Cohen agreed that Cohen should come up with his own Diana Ross vehicle. He had recently read a script by Bob Merrill. That's the dude who's a lyricist for Funny Girl, right? It was about a New York model who meets a politician who stutters. This girl assists him in getting over his speech impediment, and in the meantime, goes on to become a famous fashion model. Richard Harris was Meryl's choice for the male lead, and his choice for the female was Barbara Streisand. Streisand was like, no, I don't want to do that movie. That movie's stupid. Because Barbara Streisand passed on it. Cohen was like, ooh, but let me take the idea, okay? Because it's a good one, and it's going to work. But what you can't do, keep this in mind, what you can't do is never, ever, 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 ever tell Diana Ross that the movie that she about to do was turned down by Barbara Streisand. What? It's not good enough for Barbara Streisand? Therefore, it is not good enough for D. Diana. I mean, okay. When I look back at Lady Sings the Blues and Mahogany and, you know, The Wiz too, I do think that she was a little overage for The Wiz, but I think she did an excellent job with acting. Far better than what I think anybody would conceive that she would. Cohen remembered, Bob Merrill and I thought, hey, we should do a film about a black woman who wants to be a fashion designer and who has to have this shitty job just to pay the bills. And she'll have a black boyfriend who's a politician and he wants her to devote herself to his cause. But all she wants to do is get up, out, and away from the misery and poverty of her background. Eventually, she meets a fashion photographer who wants to turn her into a model, but he's off his rocker. When she goes to Europe and becomes a big shot model, she misses her boyfriend and feels empty inside. Diana was cautious about the idea, okay? Because Bird and sold her a lot of dreams, okay? That's one thing that them niggas will do, and they will change their mind at the last minute, okay? When you dealing with somebody like that, they very optimistic, okay? Very optimistic. Yeah, we can sell over the rainbow. Yeah, you just name it, baby. You just name it. So in a way, when I think at it, I can see the appeal of Berry Gordy, because he's so optimistic and so positive about things and is so loyal to you when he chooses you, you know, that you will follow him to the moon. Okay, I can see that. But still, I still think it's some chicken bones and bat juice buried outside of Hitsville, USA. Okay, Diana is kind of like, you sure, Barry? Because like I said, buried and sold her some dreams before that was going to happen. That never happened. Now, because Donna Ross is ambivalent about the situation, okay, Ron goes to her and was like, this is the idea. Diana's still looking at him sideways. You're not about to goop me. You're not about to get me all happy, you know, because I love fashion. You know I love fashion. Ron is like, oh, so you love fashion? How about this? She's a fashion designer, but how about we make you the actual fashion designer? Diana's like, you mean I can design my wardrobe for Mahogany? Now that I know that piece of information, that makes the movie even better. Okay, so that tells you that Diana is absolutely a fashion icon. And so is Tracee Ellis Ross, but we gotta remember that she goes in her mammy's closet to shop all the time. Tony Richardson is this British director who buried the Gordy chose. Let's use that white man. Okay, and get him over here, you know. Plus, he know how to work with a Diana Ross. We need him in our life, okay? You know, he'd be gentle with my diamond, okay? So that's how he came into play. What Bird of Gordy and Diana didn't know was that Tony Richardson thought that Lady Sings the Blues was dreadful. Everything about it was dreadful. We got problems on the cusp, okay? We got problems awry, but we don't know it yet. Tony Richards, remember, the first thing to deal with was Barry's mafia. He always had these goons about, and I had heard that he was perfectly capable of acting in a very violent way.
Well, yeah.
Later, I learned that when he walked down the street, there would be four gunmen with him, two in the front and two in the back. But I enjoyed this. I actually enjoyed the dangerous side of Barry Gordy.
Was Tony Richardson gay?
John Byram, who provided the first screenplay of Mahogany, remembered the first time he met Diana Ross at a chic Hollywood restaurant. She pulled out this thick notebook, and every page was filled with lists and lists of ideas
and questions. She want to be a part of this. You going to be using me?
So now she wants to be more active in her actual development in the entertainment world. And I respect it. Why not, girl? You need to get some of them damn credits just like everybody else do. The matter of casting Mahogany was at hand. So far, only Billy Dee Williams was definite. Rob Cohen, John Byron, Diana Ross and Barry Gordy met one afternoon in Gordy's office to decide about the rest of the cast. Okay, Diana, you pick who you want to work with. How about him? Diana said, pointing to an actor. Because, you know, they got the book, the Screen Actors Guild book in front of them. You know, Diana excited. Him, I want him! Girl, could you imagine? Barry would lean over and look at the picture. There he would scratch his head and turn to Rob Cohen. How much? Too much, Rob would say. And then he'll whisper a figure in Barry's ear. Barry Winston said, gee, that's a whole lot, Diane. Who else would you like? Diana continued flipping through the pages. Finally, she made another choice. Jack Nicholson. Oh, I love Jack Nicholson. Barry again. Jack, I don't know. Did he do The Shining yet? I don't know. Did he do One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest yet? I don't know. That nigga got a lot of, you know, meat and potatoes under his belt, girl. I don't know. So Barry the Gordy's like, maybe not that one either, Diane. Maybe that Nick. No. Jesus Christ. It's that much for Jack Nicholson? Finally, they settled on Anthony crazy ass psycho Norman Bates Perkins. That ninja is nuts in real life. You can't tell me otherwise. If I seen him on one side of the street, I would cross to the other side of the damn street. I'm not taking no chances with that crazy motherfucker. Is he still alive? Because Psycho, it warped me, man. It warped me. I ain't even gonna lie.
Girl,
if you thought that we had tea with the Murray Wilson, you need to come on and check out this Billy Dee and Diana Ross tea. You heard me? You better come get, because never in my life would I ever think this part
would be true.
The only point of contention I remembered is that Diana didn't want Billy Dee Williams in the movie. John Byram recalled, "Nigga, you say what? One of the greatest romantic teams in the world? There is no romantic collab greater in acting. If y'all know one, put it below.
Okay, I'm talking about black love.
There is no bigger standard for black love than Diana Ross and Billy Dee Williams. And you mean to tell me Dee Diana didn't even like this nigga?"
She kept saying, "Do we have to have Billy Dee? But why?"
"One of the reasons I wanted to write the screenplay was because I wanted to duplicate the Lombard Gable quality the two of them shared in Lady Sings the Blues. But we found out quickly during rehearsals for Mahogany that Billy Dee had spent too much time sitting in his home in the Hollywood Hills getting rusty. By the time he got to Mahogany, he was weak. Diana just didn't feel comfortable with him anymore. I also didn't get the impression that they liked each other very much."
You say what on the nigga? You say what?
Girl, my whole life is ruined. I might as well just pack my shit up and go. Before principal photography began, it was decided Diana would record the theme for the movie. "Do you know where you're going to?" The song had been floating around Motown for years, and singer Thelma Houston had a version of it that was, you know, just chilling.
The people found out about the song. Tell Thelma Houston, girl, we love you, girl, but you can't have this song. Not this one. This was going to the Diana. Okay? Get with it. You know how I work around here. You ain't Diana, so Thelma, go back in the corner. And I'm sorry, girl. I'm sorry.
When Rob Cohen heard it, he was struck by the lovely melody and used his influence with Barry to have Thelma's version killed. When Rob Cohen heard it, he was struck by the lovely melody and used his influence with Barry to have Thelma's version killed. Barry agreed with Rob that this was the perfect Diana Ross love theme. By this time, trouble began brewing between Tony Richardson and Rob Cohen. Richardson felt that Cohen was too inexperienced to handle the monolithic project and was unhappy with many of Cohen's decisions. "I was young and naive," Cohen said, "but it was my picture, and I would be damned if I was going to let him try to rule the roost." Like, share to Facebook, subscribe, and visit uptopbeauty.com. Now remember this. The same people that you meet on the way up will always be the same people that you meet on the way down. My naysayers, my patron loves, you babies. Y'all better have a good one. Be safe and get vaccinated.